All right, and welcome back, guys. So a question I get a ton on stream is, what is your current class setup you're using? What is your best class setup for this weapon, that weapon, whatnot? So in this video, we're gonna be going over every single AR in the game and showing what I would recommend for the best class setup to use in zombies. So the first thing we're gonna do here, we're gonna start off with the XM4, and we're gonna go over every single attachment I would personally run on the XM4. I'm gonna explain why I'd run them and what we're gonna do. And then I'm not gonna go over every single weapon like that because it would take a very long time. And the reason we're going to break down specifically the XM4, because I'm going to explain my reasons for picking what attachment I do. Now, the attachments I run on the XM4 are almost the exact same attachments I would run on every single AR in the game, with a few minor discrepancies. So at the end of the video, I'm going to go through and show every AR and every attachment that I would run on each individual AR, but only watch that if you're looking for a very specific weapon or whatnot, because like I said, the main part you need to focus on are the main attachments I run on the XM4, and for the most part, you can just use those on every AR you would like. Now, like I said, this video is just going to be for the ARs. Let me know what classes you'd like to see next. If you guys like this video and it does well, I'll potentially do maybe SMGs, snipers, LMGs, and kind of go through all of them. But AR seems to be the most requested weapon class category. So with that, let's go ahead and go into these attachments, guys. So starting off is the optic, and this one is probably the most subjective because optics are optic. Whatever is the best for you is what's the best. In zombies, I wouldn't run anything with too high end of a magnification. Honestly, I don't see any point of needing a thermal or like a 2x scope or a 4x scope in zombies. Really, there's definitely no need for that. I specifically run the Microflex. I used to run the Diamondback, but it covers too much of the screen with this little part right here. So I found probably the most helpful for me in zombies is definitely just this one right here. Kind of just chill with this on pretty much every gun that I run optics on. And just to go a step farther, I'm gonna kind of show you the reticle I use for this. And just by playing zombies, after you get 250 kills with it, you will unlock the Apex scope. Works for both multiplayers and zombies, but this is the scope that I run on this. It's just very simple, very clean, easy to use. Just a little triangle. None of this extra jazz that kind of covers up your screen. So I usually just run the Apex on it. Now moving on to the muzzle. And one of the most important things about the muzzle is this can give you increased equipment drop rates, which essentially this is like armor, like the C4 and the extra stuff like this. Very, very helpful stuff, especially for high rounds. You're getting monkey bombs and getting armor early on, stuff like that. All very awesome. I almost always tend to run the very last one. And if you look at it, yes, it does take away 33% effective damage range. But in zombies, I'm almost always shooting these weapons at very close range. I'm usually sitting on the top of Penthouse or below at the bottom of Pack-a-Punch. I'm never really shooting zombies at these max damage profiles anyway, so I'm still going to be doing the max damage most of the time. And it does take away negative 30% bullet velocity, which is a little annoying because it means your bullets are going to be a little bit slower and hit the target a little bit later. But once again, if you're shooting things close range, it's really not going to make much of a difference. In zombies, a lot of this range thing, whereas in multiplayer, it's very important, but the engagement ranges in zombies are a lot closer than what they are in multiplayer, and it's not going to affect it too much. Now, the reason I do choose this one over the other one is this only gives you 7% vertical recoil control, but it does give you that increased drop rate. Now, this top one, the SOCOM, I could see, depending on your playstyle, this one might be better for you. It does give you that increased equipment drop as well, gives you an extra 10% vertical recoil control. But the reason I don't run this one personally is that negative 10% shooting move speed. When I'm camping on top of Penthouse, when I'm training anywhere, a lot of times I'm ADS'd while I'm shooting. I'm aiming, ADS'ing, kind of walking backwards, getting those headshots, getting those critical kills. And that negative 10%, I could definitely notice it. And that to me is the reason I don't run this. But if you find yourself hip firing a ton without ADSing and moving, you might want to go for this one because you get that extra, or you get less vertical recoil control and you're not getting that negative bullet velocity. So this one's a little subjective depending on kind of your play style. I could see an argument made for both of these. I couldn't really see any other options because you don't want to be using this because the vertical, like, you don't get that extra equipment drop rate. And this one does the same thing, but it just doesn't give you vertical recoil control. So I don't really be running the suppressor or anything like that. Really, these two, just depending on your play style, which one works best for you. Me, I'm going to be using the agency suppressor personally. Which is a funny note. I remember when they originally added suppressors and zombies, it was kind of just like a haha thing. But now, you find yourself using with the gunsmith. Now you find yourself using suppressors quite often in zombies, and it's just weird to me because it always used to be kind of a joke, like when people were able to put like suppressors and zombies, it was like, ah. But with this and in Black Ops 4, I remember Black Ops 4, I think it gave you increased drop rates for power-ups or something like that. But yeah, it's just kind of funny that suppressors actually do have the better effects on them, and I find myself using suppressors and zombies more than I find myself not using them. Now moving on to the barrel attachment, and I almost always find myself running the very last one because you get that plus 7% damage, and it is the only barrel that gives you that plus extra percent damage. On top of that, you get effective damage range and bullet velocity, and this is a bigger positive than the negatives we received from the last time. Now for the barrel, I do end up running almost always either the Task Force barrel or the one that gives the extra armor damage. So for the Task Force, you're getting that extra 7% damage, which extra damage is always good, especially when you pack a punch and whatnot. Gives you effective damage range, and this effective damage range and the bullet velocity makes up for the negatives we had with the other attachments. It does take away negative 17% max starting ammo. However, that's not your overall ammo count and how much is in your magazine. It's just your starting ammo, and from what I've tested, it doesn't even seem to really make a difference. It says it gives you negative stuff here, but I still spawn in with the same amount of ammo and whatnot, so I'm not 100% sure what this does in zombies, but if it does actively negatively impact something, it's so like non-noticeable, I can't even figure out exactly what it's doing. And then you get less vertical recoil control and horizontal recoil control, but recoil control in zombies doesn't matter too much. That extra 7% damage is really nice. Sometimes I have tried around and messed around, and it is also kind of nice to use this extra armor damage. And what this does is break the armor off of the armored zombies a little bit quicker. Not the best thing ever because you don't even see them till around 20 plus. And usually by then, if you're not grinding specifically for camos, that's kind of when you're starting to get ray guns and wonder weapons. And I don't know, I find I get more useful out of the Task Force barrel because this isn't even effective until round 20 plus when armor dudes start showing up. And if you're grinding for camos, I could see you running this, and that was when I actually used this quite a bit when I was grinding for camos. But if you're past the whole camo grinding stage, you've got Dark Aether, you're just looking for some decent starting weapons just to kind of use on some classes, I'd recommend the Task Force or this if you're still looking to get some of those camos and whatnot and you're taking those guns into the higher and higher rounds. Now for the body attachment, I'm pretty much always going to recommend for every single gun this very, very final sight here. One, it's going to give you increased salvage drop rate, and on top of that, plus 30% hip fire accuracy, both two amazing things you want in zombies. And yeah, there's other sights that give you increased salvage drop as well. But from what I've heard, they give you less, and they don't give you that extra 30% hipfire accuracy. This is the best of both worlds. Gives you a little bit more salvage, and it gives you the hipfire accuracy. I couldn't imagine running any other thing in the body attachment. This is probably the most important attachment in zombies. Definitely want to be running this Ember sighting point on just about any gun that has it. Now for the underbarrel attachment, I almost always find myself using the one that gives you 3+3s here just because it gives you some movement speed, sprint movement speed, shooting movement speed, and aim movement speed. I know this one gives you fives in three different categories, but it doesn't give you that sprinting movement speed. I just kind of use this barrel to kind of make things a little bit quicker for these starting rounds. I definitely don't want to be doing this because it gets rid of some of your movement speed. And some bad negatives here, and almost always I find myself just running the bruiser grip. It's not a huge helpful thing, but definitely better than some of the other attachments. Now for the magazine, this one is kind of always the easiest, almost always going for that very, very bottom attachment. And the reason I go with this one is there's no other magazine that gives you a quicker reload quickness, and it gives you the most magazine ammo capacity and just general ammo capacity. And all it takes away is negative ADS time, which in multiplayer, this would be a big deal. But trust me, in zombies, that quicker reload speed, that magazine capacity and all that stuff is way more important than your ADS. And yeah, you're gonna notice the ADS hit, but trust me, definitely wanna be running that bottom tier magazine at all times. Now for the handle, I find myself recently, I've been using just the plus 10% ADS time. Flinch resistance, not too helpful. Aim while going prone. Sometimes we mess around and drop shot zombies, but really not that big of a deal. Not something really that's going to help you at all. This is just flinch resistance. And then this one does give you the plus 15%, but it's that negative 12% sprint to fire time. I really don't want that while in zombies. I kind of want to be able to immediately stop sprinting and shoot as quick as possible. And the plus, the extra stuff they give you isn't too important. So I've been running the speed tape for the most part when it comes to the handle. I think overall, it's probably the better one to run. This category in general doesn't make too much of a difference, but speed tape is what I'd recommend. Now for the stock, the very last attachment slot, I'd recommend running the one that gives you the plus 10% sprint to fire time. The reason I don't run the very last one that gives you the plus 30% sprint to fire time is that negative 30% hip fire accuracy. Like, you really don't want hip fire accuracy being affected in zombies, and a lot of these do that, so I don't use any of these. And so if you're looking at ones that don't affect your hip fire accuracy, you're really looking at aim walking movement speed, which not that big of a deal in zombies. It does make the stock of this gun look amazing though. The Duster stock, which gives you slide speed, but I think the best and the most effective one is kind of the sprint to fire, and that's what I run for the most part. So those are really the attachments that I would recommend on the XM4, and a lot of the stuff that I've said directly relates to every single AR in the game. And like I said, at the end of this video, I'm gonna have kind of a quick little snippet showing you the attachments that I would run on every single AR. So if you just want to see the exact attachments, don't want to hear any of the extra stuff, just go to the end of the video. We're gonna go order by order, starting with the XM4, and have kind of a listing of every attachment that I would personally recommend running on your class in that. But yeah, with that, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up, guys. So that was my attachments for the assault rifle. Like I said, at the end of the video, stay tuned if you wanna see the specific attachments for any specific AR in the game. But yeah, if you guys wanna see more videos like this, go ahead and let me know. We have the SMGs, the TAC rifles, LMG, snipers, pistols, shotguns, any class you wanna know, leave it in the comments, and that might be the video I cover next. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.